Humans originally in high school joined millions of people around the country who enjoyed the solar eclipse. During a solar eclipse, the moon passes between the Earth and the sun. Here on Earth, we can see parts of the sun behind the moon. But even looking at the sun when it's covered can still cause some eye damage. During the solar eclipse, the moon will be a new moon. A solar eclipse is the only way to see a new moon. The path of the eclipse starts in Oregon and ends at South Carolina and will cover 14 states. Originally, we will not see a total eclipse, but the sun will be almost completely covered by the moon. The next eclipse will take place in 2018. It will cover parts of Asia, Russia, and Canada.
We talked to Ridgeland High School students to find out how they thought the August 21st eclipse would go.
Well, I definitely think it's pretty interesting that this hasn't happened in our area since 1918, and our grandchildren won't even be able to see something like this.
The upcoming eclipse is going to be my first time seeing it, so I think it's going to be pretty cool. I think it'll be really cool. I think it'll be fun. Me and a bunch of ROTC people, we're going to go to Nashville and actually, you know, see it right under it. So I think it'll be pretty cool.
I think the solar eclipse are going to be pretty cool, you know.
It's just not something that you can participate in every day. So I'm glad to be looking at it, but of course with my glasses on.
I think that we're like a very lucky human like population at this moment that we get to experience the eclipse.
Well, I mean, it's going to be sort of a once in a lifetime. It's going to be a good experience for young people and also older people that most likely won't be around at that time.
I think I'm lucky to be alive right now.
Yeah,
you know, last one was like 99 years ago.
So I'm definitely looking forward to it, especially since the total eclipse is only a few miles from here and we're still going to get 99% of that eclipse. Definitely extraordinary. I can't wait. Thank you.
In my shoes, walking sleep, in my youth, I pray to keep heaven send hell away. No one seems like you.
I thought it was pretty cool. It wasn't as long as I thought it would be, but.
Black hole sun, won't you come? Wash away the rain, black hole sun, won't you come? Won't you come around? Black hole sun, won't you
come? Once in a lifetime event.
Wash away the rain, black hole sun.
In 1986, I saw an eclipse in second grade.
All I see is two big blue orbs.
We ventured out into the halls of Ridgeland High School to find out what students and faculty here thought of the eclipse.
I enjoyed the eclipse a lot. That's actually my second full eclipse in my lifetime, so it was exciting to see it again. I was in graduate school in 1979 when the last one took place, so it was great.
I felt like it was a good sight. I went and watched it down in Athens, and it was very neat.
But really, I think it was interesting. You know, hey, it was very interesting. But my first time really experiencing one.
Yeah.
But I think what really stuck out was that when everything got dark and dim, and we started hearing the crickets. So, you know, hey, it was interesting. I enjoyed it.
Many commented on the fact that we didn't get to see the eclipse in totality.
I think just the fact that it was in our area, it made it important to people in this part of the country.
And it was really neat. You could just barely see the sun when you look through your glasses, but it was still daylight outside. That was really, yeah, really cool.
While we didn't experience the eclipse in totality, many were left with the feeling of amazement.
Everybody said,
they said it was a waste of time, but I actually liked it.
Yeah, I was very excited. It was a good lifetime experience. I mean, you're not every day you're going to go out and be able to experience it like that.
Students and teachers at Ridgeland High School took advantage of a once-in-a-lifetime event to learn more about the eclipse.
The county did a lot of preparation work ahead of time
to make sure we were prepared both for safety and for organization. I loved the way the school took everybody outside and we went to the football stadium. Everybody had a pair of glasses, so safety was covered. They knew the risks, and we really got to enjoy the event.
Well, we talked about like all the precautions that we needed to take. We watched our videos about safety and all that.
While it was a learning experience, many decided not to come to school, and some ventured into the path of totality.
I think it was just good that the absences were excused, and people that came got to see it, and people that didn't come went and seen it somewhere else. So I think it was okay that school.
Some people were disappointed with the eclipse because they were not in the path of totality.
You know, I've heard so much about totality, I think I was actually a little bit disappointed. It got dark, but it didn't get that dark. It wasn't quite like nighttime. And so the eclipse itself was really, really cool, watching how the moon passed, but I wanted more of a totality experience.
Honestly, no, I don't think it was that big of a deal. It was just 30 extra minutes, and it wasn't that dangerous, so.
Some people are already looking forward to the next eclipse, even though it won't happen for a few years.
Yeah, I do. 2024 is coming up, Texas. Could always go chill at Texas, you know, watch that solar eclipse.